Welcome to all. This third Sunday of Epiphany, we are gathered together to hear the Word of God and to grow in our faith and to remember that as we are called into His kingdom, we're also called to be His fishers of men. And we'll hear the story of Jonah this morning, brought by our guest pastor, Pastor Getz. Sometimes we're not that willing to be fishers of men. We do it begrudgingly, as we see in our welcome, but God continues to work on our hearts, continues to make us stronger in our faith. And so how does that happen? Well, through His Word. As Jesus went preaching the gospel of the kingdom, saying, "The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." The time is at hand now, as we're gathered together to hear His Word, to repent, as we confess our sins at the beginning of the service, and to receive complete forgiveness. And that's where our strength, our power is to know that we are forgiven. We are His disciples, and then also sent to be fishers of men. So blessings on your worship this morning.
Jesus calling, who will go and work today? calleth, rich reward he offers thee. Who will answer gladly, saying, here am I, send me, send me. Some take up his task in mourning, to their Lord responding soon. Some are called in heat of midday, others late in afternoon. Even as the sun is setting, some are sent into the fields, there to gather in the bounty that God's word so richly yields. For as rain and snow from heaven water seeds in dusty soil, causing them to bud and flower, giving bread to those who toil. So the Lord sends forth his promise, words of life and joy and peace, never void to him returning, bearing fruit with great increase. Hearken to the Lord whose coming marks the time when grace shall end, when with his angelic reapers he in glory shall descend. Soon the night, the final harvest, soon the time for work shall cease. Then the souls his grace has garnered shall enjoy his Sabbath peace.
Please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins unto God our Father.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
From the rising of the sun to its going down, the Lord's name is to be praised.
Praise the Lord. Praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore.
The Lord is high above all nations, his glory above the heavens.
He raises the poor out of the dust and lifts the needy out of the ash heap,
that he may seat him with princes, with the princes of his people.
From the rising of the sun to its going down, the Lord's name is to be praised.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. To God on high be glory. glory and peace to all the earth. Goodwill from God in heaven, proclaimed at Jesus' birth. We praise and bless you, Father, your holy name we sing. Our thanks for your great glory, Lord God, our heavenly King. To you also begotten, the Father, Son, we pray. O Lamb of God, our Savior, you take our sins away. Have mercy on us, Jesus, receive our heartfelt cry. You with the birth of Satan at God's right hand on high. For you alone are holy, you only are the Lord. Forever and forever be worshipped and adored. You with the Holy Spirit alone are Lord Most High. In God the Father's glory, amen, our glad reply.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, mercifully look upon our infirmities and stretch forth the hand of your majesty to heal and defend us. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The Old Testament reading and sermon text is the Old Testament reading from the book of Jonah, the third chapter, beginning at the first verse. Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and preach to it the message that I tell you. So Jonah arose and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly great city, a three-day journey in extent. And Jonah began to enter the city on the first day's walk. Then he cried out and said, Yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. So the people of Nineveh believed God, proclaimed a fast, and put on sackcloth, from the greatest of them to the least. Then God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way, and God relented from the disaster that he had said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us.
Truly my soul silently waits for God. From him comes my salvation.
He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved.
How long will you attack a man? You shall be slain, all of you, like a leaning wall and a tottering fence.
They only consult to cast him down from his high position. They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, but they curse inwardly.
My soul waits patiently for God alone, for my expectation is from him.
He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved.
In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God.
Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us.
Surely men of low degree are a vapor. Men of high degree are a lie. If they are weighed on the scales, they are altogether lighter than vapor.
Do not trust in oppression, nor vainly hope in robbery. If riches increase, do not set your heart on them.
God has spoken once, twice I've heard this, that power belongs to God.
Also to you, O Lord, belongs mercy, for you render to each one according to his work. Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us.
In preparation for our gospel reading, where we hear Jesus say that he will make you fishers of men, we'll sing now the song Fishers of Men. Fishing pole, so I'm going to give one to you and one to you. See how many fish you can go find around here. Can you go catch a fish? And when you catch it, go put it in the bag. You see any fish around here? Yeah, that's how you do it. You have to get it on the end of your fishing pole, drop it in the bag. There you go. Good, you got one. Uh-oh, it got away.
Got away.
All right, you guys are doing really good. I'll get you. Let you get one more fish. That's a tough one to catch. He was just sort of nibbling on your bait there. There you go. All right. Now I want to tell you a little story about fishing. You see, Jesus, he found his disciples. They were out mending their nets after a day of fishing. And Jesus came to them and said, I'm going to make you fishers of men. That was James and John and Peter and Andrew. Fishers of men. And look on your fishing pole, Joy. You have something different on yours. What's on the end of your pole? A cross. Yeah, how about if I give you the microphone so you can let everyone tell? What's on the end of your pole? Speak into the microphone. A cross. Right. Because that's how Jesus catches men, with the gospel, the good news of his love, that he died for all men and women and children and forgives them their sins. And I'd like to sing a song to you about fishers of men. It's a real easy one. It goes like this.
I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men. Come and follow me. Come and follow me. Come and follow me. I will make you fishers of men. Come and follow me.
Now, how does God make fishers of men? Well, he does it with the power of his word, and especially through baptism. And God's word tells us this in Matthew 28. Can you say it with me now? Go, therefore. Speak real loud. I'll get off the mic's up. Go, therefore, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And lo, I'll be with you always to the end of the age. Through baptism, God makes disciples. And so here's a second verse we're going to sing. It goes like this. Go and make disciples of men, disciples of men, disciples of men. Go and make disciples of men. Go and baptize. Go and baptize. Go and baptize. Go and make disciples of men. Go and baptize. And we've been hearing these past Sundays that the water washes our sins away. And so you can see on this cross here, there's the word man, and it's red because of our sins. But God's word with water washes our sins away, and we're united to Jesus' death and his resurrection by a baptism, and he forgives you and makes you his disciple. Wow. Makes you a fisher of men, and you know what? Makes you a new person, and that's what this color green is all about, a new life. You have new life in you. And what do you do as a fisher of men? Well, you go and you teach also. You teach, you learn, you grow in your faith, so you can tell others. Here's another verse for you guys. Go and teach men all I command, all I command, all I command. Go and teach men all I command in my word of life. In my word of life, in my word of life. Go and teach men all I command in my word of life. God's word is life, and he makes you guys lights. Lights of his word to the world, that you shine your word, his light, his love to others. And hold fast to the word of life. That's what it says in Philippians chapter 2. And you're never going to be alone as fishers of men, because God gave his promise. He said to you, I will be with you always and forevermore. Let's sing one more time.
I will always be with you now, be with you now, be with you now. I will always be with you now and forevermore. And forevermore, and forevermore. I will always be with you now and forevermore.
And that's what this yellow magnet symbolizes. Eternity, eternal life, that we're with God forever, both now and in heaven. So, you guys are fishers of men. He's made you his children through baptism. Now you have the joy of go telling others that Jesus loves them. Go now, shine your light, tell others that Jesus loves them, and catch some men for Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The epistle for today is from the letter of St. Paul, the first letter of St. Paul to the Christians at Corinth. From 1 Corinthians chapter 7, these are verses 29 through 31. Paul wrote, "But this I say, brethren, the time is short, so that from now on, even those who have wives should be as though they had none, those who weep as though they did not weep, those who rejoice as though they did not rejoice, those who buy as though they did not possess, and those who use this world as not misusing it. For the form of this world is passing away." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now after John was put in prison, Jesus came to Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." And as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. Then Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men." They immediately left their nets and followed him. When he had gone a little further from there, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who also were in the boat mending their nets. And immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired servants and went after him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated.
Oh. soul and lead you to your heavenly home. Let us follow Christ our Lord and take his cross appointed. Suffering be undaunted for those who bear the battle strain,
the crown of heavenly life obtain.
To Pastor Weber, the members and guests of Immanuel Lutheran Church in Mercedes, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I don't know if you noticed that the Old Testament reading began, "Then the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time." Well, what was the first time? The first time is when God came to Jonah and said, "I want you to go to Nineveh and tell them what I want them to hear." So Jonah got into a boat and went the opposite direction. And you know the story. Well, from those of us from Minnesota, it's a fish story. But it's more than a fish story. The fish was only incidental. The story was about Jonah, who didn't want to do what God wanted him to do. The fish was to get Jonah's attention to have him change his mind. And I suppose after 3 days inside of a fish, you might have a change of heart at that point. So that's when God came to Jonah the second time. "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you." So this time, Jonah arose and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now, Nineveh was an exceedingly great city, 3 days' journey in breadth, and he cried, "Yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, put on sackcloth from the greatest of them to the least of them. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil way, God relented of the evil which he had said he would do to them, and he did not do it. The miraculous story of the fish is not the main point in the book of Jonah. Again, the reason that he was swallowed is because he refused to do what God told him to do. And it was that refusal and miraculous survival that brings about then the second visit of God. Jonah did go to Nineveh this time. And there he preached a very successful sermon. So that's the title. I don't know if you noticed the bulletin, "A Successful Sermon." That's not Pastor Getz's sermon. That's Jonah's sermon, is a successful sermon. If I were God, I would do things differently. I would not entrust the important message of repentance and forgiveness to human beings. I'd use angels. They're more reliable than people. People sometimes rebel and go the opposite direction. Stubborn cowards like Jonah. But God uses such people as his messengers, his sermon preachers, people who are themselves sinners. Although again, like Jonah, repentant sinners. And like Jonah, sometimes growing and learning a little bit more day by day in faith and knowledge. God uses sinners who have themselves experienced God's mercy. Okay, maybe not inside of a fish, but we pastors have known what God's mercy is all about. We have been sent and moved by God and his Holy Spirit because we have learned the message of repentance, and we've learned the message of God who relents, God who is merciful. And we know God and his capabilities. We know his wrath against sin. That was the point at Nineveh. Tell them, 40 days, and God's wrath will come upon you. We know of God's wrath. It's given to us explicitly in the flood. But we also know of God's mercy when he saved 8 people. Mr. and Mrs. Noah, Mr. and Mrs. Shem, Mr. and Mrs. Ham, Mr. and Mrs. Japheth. Saved 8 people, but only 8 people in his mercy. We know God's wrath at Sodom and Gomorrah with the fire and brimstone. Well, in my opinion, Nineveh really deserved God's wrath. In antiquity, Nineveh had a reputation for the extremes of cruelty and violence, and their armies were feared because they were so violent and wicked. Now we can say, well, that's Nineveh. That's not you and me. We have not murdered or tortured, but we may have harbored hatred. And like Jonah, maybe rebellion against God or lethargy and laziness, maybe even from time to time opposition to God's word or God's will in our lives. Those are sins. They deserve and demand God's punishment, a death, an eternity in hell. God's wrath is seen by you and me in its fullest consequences on Good Friday, when God laid the sins of the whole world on the Son Jesus, who cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Why? Because God wants all men to be saved. Even people in a cruel, wicked city as huge as Nineveh. I can't picture a city 3 days' journey, walking 3 days to get from one side of the city to the other. I think that the largest city that I've seen is Beijing, China, 21 million. Apparently, Nineveh rivaled that. There are many people in this world, in lands other than our own. I have been blessed to visit the land called Ghana in West Africa. Pastor has been in Central and South America with the message of God's word. We dare not shrink from the task, as Jonah tried to do. God wants all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. So he sends messengers. Messengers to proclaim, to preach sermons. Sometimes successful sermons. Sometimes the hearers will take the sermon to heart, but it's not the preacher. It's not about Pastor Weber or Pastor Gedd. Only God can change hearts. Only the Holy Spirit can move people. I believe that I cannot, by my own reason or strength, believe in Jesus Christ, my Lord, or come to him. But the Holy Ghost has called me by the gospel, enlightened, sanctified, kept me in the faith. That, my friends, is the miracle of the book of Jonah. Not a fish story. A miracle greater than the swallowing of a fish of a human being. Although, again, that could change a person's mind or his heart. I'm not sure how sincere it would have been. But you and I have admitted it again this day. I heard you say it. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But again, if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, will forgive our sins, and will cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Jonah didn't seem to preach in his sermon the grace of God. And that really puzzles me. Where did that gospel message come from? How did they know? I don't know. Isn't it strange how the Holy Spirit worked? He preached 40 days and God will come with his wrath. And that 40 days is a reminder to you and me. It's a symbol of a preparation time. It's a symbol of what we shall shortly enter into when we begin the Lenten season, our penitential season, when we repent of our sins. Symbolic for what Paul in our epistle lesson talked about when he said there, the time is short. 40 days, God's wrath will come. Who knows when God's wrath will come for each of us? So we preach sermons, like Jonah. Sermons that occasionally bring forth fruits of repentance. Jonah went, but only after God's second call. Jonah went and proclaimed God's wrath so that the people had to despair of their sins and hope for God's mercy. Imagine that miracle. They humbled themselves. Inwardly and outwardly, God saw their works, not the mere words, but their actions also, telling what was in their hearts. They bore what we call the fruits of repentance, showing that their lives were changed by that sermon from Nineveh, that sermon of Jonah. And thus they were spared God's wrath. That really is the message of the scriptures, is it not? Repent and believe the gospel, and God will spare us from the wrath and judgment day. It might be interesting to know the rest of the story at Nineveh. The story about how Jonah then became angry because God didn't destroy Nineveh. That wasn't much of a preacher, was it? He didn't want his hearers to be saved. He wanted them to be damned. But God had other plans. Yet, even though Nineveh repented, scarcely a century later, backsliding Nineveh was destroyed. Which just goes to show you, folks, one sermon can't last a lifetime. So often we will see people moved by a successful sermon to dedicate their lives to the Lord. And then, shortly thereafter, some weird opinions and ideas will take over, replacing the faith that had been planted there. God's gospel message is so simple. A child can know and understand it. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Our sins are forgiven because God laid the sins on Jesus. We all know that. But it's so easily forgotten and so often perverted. And what's even worse, the people who pervert the gospel think that they're on the right track because they're going to help out God by what they're doing with their lives. And now my repentance earns God's favor. No, friends. God is merciful to whom he will be merciful. You see, you and I know something that Jonah and Nineveh did not know. God, through the person of his son Jesus, used Jonah and his preaching as an illustration. God used Jonah through the words of Jesus himself. At one point, as recorded in the Gospel of Matthew, so people were testing Jesus and said, show us some sign so we can believe in you. Give us a miracle. Show us something. And Jesus said, I'm not going to give you any sign except this, the sign of Jonah. As Jonah was inside the fish for 3 days, so shall the Son of Man be in the belly of the earth 3 days. Many disbelieved the Son of God. They did not believe that he would rise from the dead. Although they knew what he said, that's why they put the guards at the tomb. They disbelieved that the Son of God was among them. And even the wonderful sermons of Jesus were rejected by some of his hearers, so that he had to endure their scorn, their ridicule, their mocking, their scourging, the crucifixion, the sufferings of the Son of God. God used all their evil for our good. It was God's way of letting his Son Jesus take the punishment for our sins. And now God reckons Jesus' holiness to be accounted to ours, the penitent believers. Whether it be Nineveh or Beijing or Ghana or Mercedes, the message is the same. Every successful sermon has the same message. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Paul, in today's epistle lesson, says, the time is short. God's judgment is at hand. Today's gospel shows us that Jesus calls people to be disciples, to bring the message so that people can believe and teach Christ crucified and risen. Today's Old Testament reading, our sermon text, teaches us that God shows mercy on those who repent and believe his message. Hold fast that faith so that no one may take it from you or take you from it. And be like Jonah and bring God's word to others too. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus unto life everlasting. Amen.
Please rise and we sing together the offertory, songs of thankfulness and praise.
Songs of thankfulness and praise, Jesus Lord, to thee we raise, manifested by the star to the sages from afar. Branch of David, David's stem, in thy birth at Bethlehem, anthems thee to thee addressed, God in man made manifest. Sun and moon shall darken be, stars shall fall, the heavens shall flee, Christ will then by lightning shine, all will see his glorious sign. Within the trumpet ear, all will see the Judge appear. Thou by all will be confessed, God in man made manifest.
Peace be with you. Let us pray. Lord, as you have called us as your own, gather us together and enlighten us by your Spirit through your word. We bring to you our prayer and praise. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. We pray for all people of the world, that the Epiphany light that shines the radiance of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, shine in the hearts and minds of all people, for those who are wayward and lost, and for those who have rejected your call to repentance and faith. We pray you use us in our words and witness to point to you, that many more would faithfully follow.
O Christ, our true and only light, enlighten those who sit in night. Let those afar now hear your voice, and in your fold with us rejoice. Fill with the radiance of your grace the souls now lost in error's maze. Enlighten those whose inmost minds some dark delusion haunts and blinds.
Ever-present Lord, be with your church on earth and the congregations in their work to serve and praise you and to be nourished by your word and sacraments. Bless those who are called in roles of pastors and church workers, that they faithfully speak and live your word of truth, and that the call to repentant and faithful life in Christ be followed. Continue to raise up called servants and leaders within your church for your work and mission, to continue that many more may know you and follow where you lead.
Oh, gently call those gone astray, that they may find the saving way, that every conscience soul oppressed in you find peace and heavenly rest.
Lord of comfort and peace, be present with those who face various needs in mind, soul, and body. Especially we lift up to your loving care our brother in Christ, Lawrence, and his family. We pray for Jim and Wanda. We pray for Javier, for Bobby Sue, Alfonso, and their family. We pray for all those who are facing various trials and tests in their lives, that you would strengthen them and gather them to your fold to know of your love and your grace and mercy. Grant healing according to your will. Be with those who grieve, that the assured promise of Christ's victory over death and the grave bring hope in time of hopelessness. For those who live in doubt, fear, and distress, extend your call of grace through your word and those who proclaim it.
Shine on the dark and the cold. Recall the wanderers to your fold. Unite all those who walk apart. Confirm the weak and doubting heart.
Lord, we praise your name, for you gave Jesus Christ, whose love for us compelled him to go to the cross, that we by faith are saved. Unite us in him and in our fellowship together. Then in repentance, we faithfully receive the gifts of life and grace he gives to us through his body and blood. Help us to draw our strength, love, and compassion and mercy through you.
That they with us may evermore such grace with wandering thanks adore, an endless praise to you be given by all your church in earth and heaven.
Heavenly Father, we commend to your loving care those in our church who are not able to gather with us this morning. We pray for our shut-ins, for Erlene, for Harriet. We pray for Helen and Carolyn, and for Don and Pat. We pray for Lester. We pray for all those who look to you for their mercy and strength. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his favor upon you and give you his peace.
Amen. Amen.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light.
precious blood, lead me home.
When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call. Hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is almost gone, at the guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.